Yo, what is up? D-Man to Man is in the house, and y'all saw the title. This is my reaction to Spider-Man No Way Home, and what I think it could mean for the future of the Spider-Man, and specifically Andrew Garfield. Other great stuff. But before I get started, here's your one and only warning. If you haven't seen the movie yet, one, go to the damn movie theaters and see it, and two, don't watch this video, or do. If you want to be spoiled, I'm sure you've been spoiled by something if you haven't seen it. So, whatever. Firstly, that's disgusting. My bad. The movie. Oh my god. If we weren't in a pandemic, I would honestly believe that this would be the number one grossing movie of all time. I honestly believe. I know I said in a video a while back that I didn't think it would beat Endgame's grossing record of 2.7 billion, but damn, dude, after watching it, I honestly believe it would if the world wasn't in a pandemic. It might actually still do it. It did surpass a billion the other day. It may do it. But yeah, this is probably my favorite movie of all time. I'm not gonna lie. You know, Avengers Endgame's up there. Honestly, the very first original SpongeBob movie was on there. Yeah. The Plankton takes over, King Neptune freezes, Mr. Krabs, you get it, yeah, blah, 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 that's up there. I honestly believe this might just be number one, my number one favorite movie of all time. They brought back all the old villains, they brought back the two Spider-Man, Tobey Maguire's and Garfield's, of course, Holland's was in there, we saw him and Zendaya's, Michelle Jones, MJ, the relationship really take effect. The storyline with Mysterio, it was, exposed. It was amazing. It was amazing. Seeing Matt Murdock, Charlie Cox's Matt Murdock in there, and then a little hint with his echolocation senses when he caught, that was awesome. That was, teasing. He'll probably be back in the future. That's going to be awesome. This movie, really, the only thing I can really say anything about, and I might be, nitpicking or cherry picking, I really wish an enemy from Tom Holland's movies had returned. Specifically, I really wish Mysterio wasn't dead, and I wish he was in this movie, or maybe Vulture, but he showed up in the Morbius trailer, though, which means maybe during the thing and not everyone came in, he went to Sony's universe, and then for some reason couldn't come back, or maybe it's happening at the same time. I don't know, but, something like that, and then that would have been kind of cool, but this movie was amazing. I think they've done Andrew Garfield Spider-Man and Tobey Maguire Spider-Man justice for them not getting their next film like they were originally planned to. I think it was awesome. Dude, my favorite scene was when Andrew Garfield Spider-Man caught MJ. I remember watching Gwen Stacy die in The Amazing Spider-Man 2 in theater, and I remember crying. I remember crying, because I love his Spider-Man. I love his movies, although the second one's a little, I loved him. I loved his portrayal of Spider-Man. It was amazing. And watching her die, oh, it was so sad. And when he catches her, oh, dude, it just, I cried during that scene when he saved MJ. It was amazing. Them looking back on their past, what they've been doing since their last movie, awesome. Truly, truly amazing. Now, what will this set up for? Well, obviously Doctor Strange 2. We saw the little teaser trailer in the post-credit scene. Multiverse is cracked. It is broken. There's rumors of Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man showing back up for it. Maybe doing just a cameo. Maybe not. Hell, I've even heard maybe the original Fantastic Four showing up in the X-Men. The original X-Men. Like, Foxes. Yeah. Imagine seeing Chris Evans return, but not as Captain America, but as the Human Torch. Making a quick little cameo. That would be so cool. Although those movies weren't the best, it would still be cool. But that's that, okay? What I want to focus on is Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man and the rumors going around him being a part of the third Amazing Spider-Man and being Sony Spider-Man. And yeah, I want to sit here and talk about this for a second. I've read the rumors and the speculations. I want to put it all out there. Yes, he was my favorite Spider-Man. But I don't think, I understand Sony wanting to have their own Spider-Man in their own universe, and Andrew Garfield Spider-Man is by far the best pick. No reason to recast him and redo the whole Spider-Man story. Uncle Ben dying, blah, 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 right? No reason to do that. Use Andrew Garfield, someone who loves the character and who would want to return, and someone who could return for multiple movies because he's still, young enough and still kind of youth. I don't know. He's in his 30s. I think, yeah, he's great. He's younger than Maguire. So it's kind of perfect that way. But I think there's two reasons why they won't make a third Amazing Spider-Man movie. One, I think the way they kind of wrapped up his Andrew Garfield Spider-Man story in No Way Home. He saved MJ and he redeemed himself, and there was a spark of hope that, he doesn't have to be all depressed and moody and cold all the time now. He seemed. It was like a spark of hope, basically. The return to what Spider-Man is. He's not brutal. He holds his punches. You get it? Yeah. I think that was just a kind of a great end to his story. Now, I still think he should be Sony's Spider-Man because he could show up anywhere. Like, Morbius, hell, the next Venom 3 movie. You saw Venom in the post-credit scene of Venom, Let There Be Carnage, right? Another solid movie. He licked the screen when he saw Spider-Man. He was like, ugh, amazing. But then he didn't get to fight Spider-Man. Although a piece of him was left behind the MCU, and this is how they put Venom in the MCU. That'd be a future thing. Probably with Flash Thompson. Well, first Tom Holland Spider-Man, but then Flash Thompson as Agent Venom. That would be sick. I'm getting off track. Oh, fuck, where am I at? Anyways. But he was probably still go to New York City because he's all the way down in like San Francisco or wherever he was at to fight Spider-Man, but he won't find Holland's because he's in the MCU. He'll find Garfield's in Sony's Spider-Verse, right? And then that's probably what Venom 3 will be about, Venom versus Spider-Man. And they'll fight and fight and then probably come together to take down some common enemy. I don't know, maybe another symbiote or maybe Morbius. I don't know, Morbius. In the trailer of Morbius, you see a brief scene of Oscorp, the building. That's the same building from Garfield's movies. That's the same Oscorp building. Another reason why I think Garfield will return and be Sony's Spider-Man. And with his darker take, right, of Spider-Man, I think he fits right in to Venom, Morbius, not to mention Vulture. And then possible movies in the future, like the Sinister Six. Sony is determined to get a Sinister Six movie out. And they have a lot of villains they could be using. I think he will return, but he won't make another standalone movie. He's basically just going to be there so they can really focal around the Spider-Verse and have a Spider-Man in the center. But they might do like a Spider-Gwen movie, which she would fit right in because, right? Because of Gwen Stacy, you'd fit right in as long as Emma Stone is playing her. Of course, Venom, maybe Morbius or another Morbius movie. I don't know if Morbius is a bad guy or if he's a conflicted bad guy. He looks cool. But they'll probably, if they do this, they'll probably fight at some point down the line. Anyways, I think that's everything I wanted to cover, everything I wanted to talk about. I do hope he returns. Like I said, my favorite portrayal of Spider-Man. He had the shortest time with him, but with the character, but he loves the character so much. Oh man. And I know deep down he wants to. I think I heard an article where he wanted to come back. And I think with after filming No Way Home with Marvel Studios and Sony, I think any distaste from one another, bitterness between one another, that went out the window. I think they were able to fix that relationship. So now he's more likely to return. Got it? Anyways, No Way Home was amazing. S, like if I was ranking them like S, A, B, C, S tier up there with like Endgame and Infinity War. Amazing. Loved it. Love it. Possibly my favorite fucking movie. And I really hope it comes back. There's a lot of rumors of Garfield's Spider-Man returning. Not to mention, apparently, three more movies that Tom Holland's Spider-Man is going to be doing. That's going to be cool considering how No Way Home ended. With everyone forgetting he's him and he kind of just letting MJ and Ned go at the end. You know. It's going to be really good. It's going to be really cool. I can't wait. Now, it seems like Tom Holland's going to be taking some time off to start a family. Dude's like, I don't know, a few months older than me. And I don't want to start a family. But, you know, if he and Zendaya are ready for that, go ahead. Be happy. Make some cute Tom Holland Zendaya babies. And then come back to play Spider-Man. That would be awesome. But anyways, I'm done chit-chatting. Like and subscribe, all the great stuff. And I'll catch y'all on the next one. And hit the notification bell. I messed up my outro. I don't care. You know what to do. Thanks and have a great day. Happy New Year, too. Peace.